friends, welcome back to my channel. Today I am going to discuss part 4 of full mouth rehabilitation. I hope you have all learned the parts 1, 2 and 3 of full mouth rehabilitation. Let's discuss the part 4 of FMR. In this lecture, I would like to discuss methods of recording centric relation. Let's discuss what is centric relation. According to GPT-9, the centric relation can be defined as a maxillomandibular relationship. It is independent of tooth contact. Here the condyles articulate in the anterior superior position against the posterior slopes of articular eminences. In this position, the mandible is restricted to a purely rotary movement. From this unstrained physiologic maxillomandibular relationship, the patient can make vertical, lateral or protrusive movements. It is a clinically useful, repeatable reference position. So this is very important. Why your question? That is, define centric relation according to GPT-9. This is the concept of long centric. It is given by Dawson. Here it is the horizontal freedom. This is the centric relation. And this is the posterior closure, and here it is the amount of long centric. Okay. In this picture, it shows the flat long centric is not needed on the posterior teeth, even if it is incorporated into the anterior gyrus. Here, in this picture, the condyles cannot move horizontally forward because they are up against the eminentia at the centric relation. And this picture shows. Here they must move downward from the centric relation to protrude the mandible, and the molars must move down with the condyles. Here the molars must move down with the condyles. So the condyles move downward from the centric relation to protrude the mandible, and the molars move down with the condyles. Okay. In this picture, it shows the centric relation record. Here the centric relation record, which transfers the tooth relationships at the centric relation from the patient to the articulator. This is the articulator, and here the centric relation record transfer from the patient to the articulator. And it is noted that centric relation record should never be perforated. This is very important. This picture shows the incorrect centric relation recording. Here the mandible is forced backward, then the condyles are not in there. More superior position, and but they are moved backward and downward. Here it is a small arrow which denotes the backward and downward movement of the condyle. And in this relation, the restorations made on the cast related to this record are at supraocclusion when tried in the mouth. Here the relationship of the anterior teeth noted in this picture C. Okay. And this is the picture showing the manipulation of patient's mandible into centric relation. This is the bimanual technique, and here this is the single-handed technique. Now the position of dentist's thumb and fingers on the mandibular border. Okay. And this is the anterior programming device which is used to facilitate the centric relation recording. Here the autopolymerizing resin is mixed and adapted to the maxillary central incisors, and the patient's mouth is guided into closure and stopped when the posterior teeth are about 1 mm apart. The indentations are used as a gate during the trimming of the device, and the completed device should allow the patient to make smooth lateral and protrusive movements. An inclined contact area must be avoided because it will tend to cause the mandible to retrode excessively. Alternatively, a thermoplastic material can be used. After softening and positioning, the mandible is guided into centric relation closure. The device is trimmed with a scalpel. Again, the posterior disclusion is verified. Here the cross-section view through the device is illustrated, and these pictures I and J. Here the plastic leaf gauge may be used to prevent the habitual closure into maximal intercuspation. Okay. This is the centric relation recording technique. This is the armamentarium used in the centric relation recording technique. Okay, here the reproducibility of centric relation position is verified because the centric relation has to be reproduced several times while the record is made. Here is it. Sheet of soft aloe wax is adapted to the maxillary arch. This is the picture showing the piece of hard pink wax is added to the lower anterior portion of the wafer. Then this is the number 7 ash soft metal is folded around the posterior border and luted to the wafer with sticky wax to increase the rigidity. The reinforced sheet is repositioned and the mandible is guided into centric relation until the pink wax provides a stop for vertical closure. Noted that the maxillary indentations capture only on the cusp tips. Some aloe wax is added to the lower incisor indentations. The record is repositioned and the centric relation closure is repeated. Here the incisor indentations are reproduced in the aloe wax. Then the additional wax is added to the area of the first molars. Then the hinge closure is repeated. Molar indentations are clearly visible. The incisor indentations should have been reproduced. Any double indentation indicates inaccuracy. Centric relation closure is repeated one more time after additional aloe wax is added to the premolar regions. Here the centric relation record is complete. Okay, that is the centric relation recording technique. This is the centric relation recording technique with hard pink base plate wax. This is the armamentarium used, and here the after being softened and folded into a double layer, record is trimmed to the appropriate shape. And the hinge movement is practiced with the patient. The record is adapted to the maxillary arch. Adaptation ensures the shallow indents of the cusp tips from canine posteriorly. And the record is trimmed through the buccal cusp tips of the premolars and molars. Then the trimmed record has this appearance. Okay, this appearance. The trimmed record has this appearance. And the wax is bent over the facial aspect of the canine teeth. Here the wax is bent over the facial aspect of the canine teeth. And the patient stabilizes the record while the hinge movement is reproduced. The frontal view of the completed record has this appearance. And not the shallow indentations which allow accurate seating of the cast. Okay. Coming to the centric relation recording technique with preformed wax wafer and the leaf gauge. This is the preformed wax and leaf gauge which are used for the occlusal registration. The leaf gauge is positioned to achieve separation of the posterior teeth. Here the leaf gauge is to achieve the separation of the posterior teeth. Here the posterior teeth separation. Then the lateral aspects of the wax are softened in a water bath. Then the wax record is adapted to the maxillary teeth. This is the wax record. It is adapted to the maxillary teeth. Then the record is trimmed through the buccal cusp tips. Then the wax is re-softened. And the patient's mandible is guided into the centric relation. And indents of the mandibular cusp tips are obtained. And the record is chilled with the cold water. Here the excess wax can be removed with a sharp blade until only indents of the cusp tips remain. After the clinical verification, the record is stored in the cold water for subsequent use in the laboratory. Okay. Here the centric relation recording using elastomeric material. This is the elastomeric material used for centric relation recording. Once the mandibular quadrants are coated, the dentist uses an anterior resin jig. This is the anterior resin jig to ensure the reproducible recording position is obtained. And the patient remains occluded until the material has set. And this is the appearance of the record before trimming. Okay. This is the picture showing gauze mesh cloth which forms with plastic holders, and zinc oxide eugenol paste can be used instead of elastomeric paste. This is the picture showing acrylic resin record bases. used to mount the partially edentulous cast. Okay, this is the acrylic resin record basis. Okay, and this is the picture showing the mounting of the maxillary cast on a whip mixed articulator. This is the armamentarium used. Here the incisal pin is removed and the condylar inclination is adjusted to a face bow setting. Here the condylar inclination is adjusted. Then the side shift is set to 0. Here the side shift is set to 0. Then the mounting plate is attached. Face bow earpieces are attached to the condylar elements. Here the face bow earpieces are attached to the condylar elements. Then the face bow is attached to the articulator. Scored maxillary cast is positioned on the face bow fork and the cast is pre-vetted. Then the mounting stone is applied to the cast and the mounting plate. The upper member of the articulator is closed until it contacts the crossbar of the face bow. Then the additional stone is added as needed. Okay, this is the mounting procedure of maxillary cast on a whip mixed articulator. Okay. This is the picture showing mounting the mandibular cast. Here, this is the procedure in dinar articulator. Here the centric relation record is positioned on the inverted maxillary cast. And the incisal gate pin is adjusted. Here the incisal gate pin is adjusted. And the mandibular cast is oriented on the in the record. Okay. And the cast is attached with the mounting stone. When the pin is raised, then the cast contact in the centric relation closure. When the pin is raised, then cast contact in the centric relation closure. Then this is the elastomeric centric relation records. They are trimmed. Okay. Centric relation records are positioned on the inverted articulator. Incisal gate pin is adjusted. The cast is stabilized and plaster is applied on to the pre-vetted cast and the mandibular mounting plate before the articulator is closed. And here the mounting is completed. This is the procedure done in whip mix articulator. Okay. That's all for today's lecture. Thanks for watching. Please do like, share and subscribe my channel for more videos.